Tractate Bava Kama, page 102. It was one of those well-known high quality of bakery. A fellow sent to the bakery a agent to go and pick up a high quality chalot and other matter for a big simcha. And it turns that the shaliach, while he got there and collected all these beautiful chalot and other things, he also bought some for himself. And the owner offered him a special card that you can just, those like a lottery cards, that you remove some and you may win something. And the fellow won a nice size amount of money. So the question is, who is that money belongs to? That's basically the core of our sugya today. Is that money belongs to the fellow that purchased the majority of that food, of that chalot and other matters, or it belongs to the shaliach, to the agent? So here we are, page 102 in Bava Kama. We start the first part of sugya in the well-known subject of Shemitah, when you're dealing with a benefit of Shemitah, and we all know that anything related to the Shemitah has to be very careful watch, because we cannot degrade it by any means. So Amar Rav Kahana. Amar Rav Kahana, ve'etzim la'asaka tanaihi. So a little bit background. We said in the previous daf that Rava asked a stira, a contradiction. In one hand, a tzim, it's a samemanim. It's good for the tzeva, for the color. But the thing is, when it's come to Shemitah, the sabbatical year, the question is how you treated that. Because the Kedushat Shvi'i, the sanctity of the sabbatical year, it depends upon the presumption, the mindset of the melaket, the one collected only when you have the tzemach, the produce, stand there for two purposes. Either, as we said, aleikanim, aleikfanim, but if it's a designated to a certain one, for example, let's say shemen, oily wood, so that's usually used for the heating purposes. So therefore, we go by the mindset of the melaket. So Amar Rav Kahana, ve'etzim la'asaka, that when we say that these pieces of wood that intended to be to purpose of heating, and therefore you don't have the kedusha shvit even for oily wood. Tanaihi, that's a disputation among the Tanaim. The Tanya, that is a Tosefta in Tractate Shvi'it. The Tosefta said as follows: Ein Mosrin Perot Shvi'it. One may not transfer wine, the sabbatical year produce, to another person. Lo Lemishra. Not for soaking flax to prepare for spinning, velo lichvusa, not for the purpose of laundering clothing, which means we not allow, Rashi said, to add wine of shvi'it, carry sanctity, to the water that used for soaking flax. Why? Because that's type of schora beperot shvi'it. The Shita Mikubetzet explains that that it's in a way, again, depend how you take it, but it's close to the matter of transactions between parties. It's schora. ורבי יוסי אומר, נותנים פירות שביעית לתורמי מישרא ולתוך הכבוסה. רבי יוסי said, you can do it, you can transfer a sabbatical year produce for soaking and for laundering. So what's the shorish, what's the root of this disputation of this Tanaim? It's the idea of Kedushat Shvi'it, as we said, the sabbatical year, the sanctity of the sabbatical year, for those oily wood, depend upon in this following disputation. Mai ta'ama de Rabbanan. What's the reason of the Tanakama that hold that you are prohibited to use the wine of sabbatical year to soak flax and to do a laundry? Because Amarkra, the Torah said in Vayikra, chapter 25, verse 6, Vehaita Shabbat Haaretz Lachem Leochla. So they said that this sabbatical year produce should be for you for food, which means the peirot shvi'it, the produce of the sabbatical year, on purpose of eating, velo lemishra, not for laundering, soaking flax. Le'ochla, again, for food, velo lichvusa, and not for laundering. Rabbi Yossi omer, that here is another source to in a sense of that pasuk, and the Amar Kra lachem ve'aita Shabbat Haaretz lachem, which means lekol tzorcheichem, whatever you have to have, whatever you need, and therefore he included a person's need of soaking flax and laundering. Now, according to the Chazon Ish, the way the Chazon Ish understand it, that's a place that they use it all year round for soaking flax and for laundry. So again, if you talk about get used to eat, that's one thing. Derech Achila, as the Mishnah in Shvi'it said, chapter 8, Mishnah 2. But Hana'a, it's a different way. Le'achla ve'lo le'efsed, again, you have to say that that's the purpose, that's the way he understands it. Chazon Ish, on Shvi'it, chapter 13, that's the way he derived it. Because the Gemara said in Pesachim 52b, Le'ochla ve'lo le'hefsed. Ve'rabanan nami, and also the sages as well, what's the way that it's written? Aktiv lachem, so it should be le'kol tzochechem, which means that the pasuk come to extend the heter, the allowance of using perot shvi'i to other benefits. So the Gemara explained and said, Lachem dumya dileochla. For you, it's similar to the sanctity of the sabbatical year takes effect with what? Bemisha na'ato ve'uro shavim. To those whose benefit and consumption coincide. And that excludes what? Yatzu mishra uchvusa. That excludes soaking and laundering, where the items benefit follow their consumption. So the Gemara said, Rabbi Yossi Nami Aktiv Lochla. It's written for food. So they said, Amar Lach Haomi Baelich Detanya, Detanya Lochla Velo Lim Lugma. For food, and not for pollutants, which means you cannot make it a tachboshet for healing. That's melolugma, as the Rambam said. But basically, it's to use it for that purpose. Rashi interprets as that's a soft, moist mass of cloth. Rav Nachshon Gaon explained that this is a kind of rinse used to clean one's mouth. But anyway, ata omer le'ochla velo le'milugma, o eno ela le'ochla velo lichvusa. So why you are derived the drasha prohibited lugma and not soaking in flax and laundry? כשהוא אומר לכם, הרי כבוסה אמור, המה אני מקיים לאוכלה, what I fulfill, that it should be for food, לאוכלה ולא למלוגמה. So the more I ask, כלומר, היית לרבות הכבוסה או להוציא את המלוגמה? Right? So they said, מרבי אני את הכבוסה ששבל בכל אדם. Which means every person needs this, the laundry, the soaking flax. So therefore, it's very similar to Ochla. That's the Rashi in Tractate Sukkah, page 40. Umotzi ani, and I exclude it elam etam lugma, sheino shave bechol adam. Why? Because as we explained, it's miyad for sick people. So most of the people doesn't need it, and that's what the Chazon Ish said, that it's like Hefsed Perot Shvi'it. But Mishra Ukvusa, it's Chayei Nefesh, it's a very basic, so therefore, Rabbi Yossi said that that's derivative, the Rabbi also said that. Derivative from the word Lachem, and it's not considering a loss. So the Gemara said, Motzin itam Gemara Shosho Bekol Adam, Kemana Aizla Adetanya, לאוכלה ולא למלוגמה, לאוכלה ולא לזילוף, לאוכלה ולעשות ממנה אפיק תביסים. So that's, you don't use it in those days, they use it for people who need to throw up. So they use it to pull it out. So that's the purpose. כמן כרבי יוסי, because that's only if the fastidious people or sick people, the Ikra Banan, Ikra Banan, Mishra Ukvusa. So that's only the view of Rabbi Yossi. So here, the big disputation between Rabbi Yossi and sages, if you're allowed to use it for Mishra and Kvusa, for a laundering and for soaking flax, it's not for those who collected those grapes for purpose of consumption, which is to eat the grapes or to drink wine from them. Because in that case, everyone agrees that this is a problematic, this is prohibited. That's what we said in Chazon Ish, in Shvi'it Yud Gimel. Only if anavim, the grapes that we made it, in order to make them from Mishra and Kvusa. That's a total different way of understanding. But anyway, but from here, when we talk about a oily wood, that he collected them in order to lighten area. So that's, according to the sages, you don't care for the mindset of the Melaket. But there are those who go the other way around. Rabbi Yehuda Omer, Ima Shevach. So now we have the abbreviation, the acronym Saban, Siman Saban, Yativ Rabbi Yossi Achure de Rabbi Abba. Kamed Ravuna, Yativ Ravuna, Kamar Lachak Rabbi Yehoshua ben Korcha, Valachak Rabbi Yehuda, Adrinu Rabbi Yosef Leapi, he was angry, Amar Bishlam Rabbi Yehoshua ben Korcha Yitzrich. Sagel Adach Amin Ayachid Rabbim Lachak Rabbim, obviously as we said many times, כמש מלן, הלכה כיחיד, אז רבי שוע מן קורחה. רבי שוע מן קורחה מעיד את תני, רבי שוע מן קורחה אומר, מלווה בשטר, which means that you have the idolater. אין נפרעים מהם before those idolaters holidays, because that's the beginning of Avodah Zarah, right? Because they said it makes them happy. That's the beginning of the Avodah Zarah, the Mishnah said there are certain things you cannot do it. שם אלוקים אחרים לא ישמע על פיך, you should not, אם הוא מעבוד לזור 6, say that is any type of make them celebrate, it's a problematic, right? מיל ועל פה, נפרעים מהם נשו כמציל מידם. Because the next day, you can deny it. אלא לך כרב יהודה, למה לי? מחלוקת ואחר כך סתם. מחלוקת ואחר כך סתם, הלך כסתם. מחלוקת בבא קמה, which is in our Mishnah, לצבוע לו אדום וצבעו שחור, שחור וצבעו אדום, רב מאיר אומר, נותן לו דצם רב יהודה אומר, אם השבח יתר על היציאה, נותן לו את היציאה ומה היציאה יתרה לשבח, נותן לו את השבח. Now, when we go by רב יהודה, סתם, בבר מציאה דתנן, כל המשנה ידוע על התחתונה. כל החוזר בו ידוע על התחתונה. So, what is the חידוש of רבונה? That he said, he hold that הלך הופע לו רב יהודה. So he said, רבונה איסטריך סגל את החמינה אין סדרה משנה. He hold that after the Rebbe teach all the Mishnayot according to the sages, he can come back and set them according to their titles. That's Rashi in the beginning of the Avodah Zarah, chapter, page 7. So, Tosfot here, the comment, because this Tosfot said, in Seder HaMishnah, the Pramim HaYashunei Shroa Al HaSeder, V'Shem HaTchila Shana Bav Metziah, V'Chag Kach Bav HaKama. אבל ודאי אחר כך סדרן רבי על הסדר, that's the Tosfot said here. So anyway, so that's the claim. But he said, הוא סתם ואחר כך מחלוקת היא, ורב יוסף יחי. כל מחלוקת ואחר כך סתם אני מעין סדר למשנה, וסתם ואחר כך מחלוקת היא, ורב הונה, כי לא אמרין אני סדר למשנה באחד המסכתא. אבל יותר מסכתא תמרינן, ורב יוסף כולה נזיק אין אחד המסכתא היא. ביבייטיימה, משום דקטן אלה, סתם משנה בב מציע, משום דקטן לגבי הלכת הפסיקתה, כל המשנה ידוע לתחתונה. Anytime you make that change, whoever changes in the term of an agreement is at a disadvantage. And whoever reneges on the agreement is at a disadvantage. כל החוזר בו ידוע לתחתונה. So because this ruling was taught with another established הלכה, it is apparent that this is also an established הלכה. Page 102b. תנו רבנן ונותן מעות לשלוחו. That's a תוספתא in בבא מציעא. One who gives money to his agent. לקח לו חיטין ולקח מהם שעורין. So he asked him to purchase for him with a plan to sell as a profit a wheat, and he purchased barley instead of wheat, and vice versa. So he said, Tani achada im pachatu, pachatu lo, vim otiru, otiru lo. So it means the agent, remember the story we said at the beginning with the bakery. So even he changed from his shlichut, so he make it. ותן אחד האם פחדו פחדו לו, פחדו לו, ואם הותירו, הותירו לאמצע, which means it's divided between the two of them. אומר רבי יוחנן, לא קשיא, רב מאיר והרב יהודה. In Mishnah, when it's guided to Tzaba, it's רב מאיר. The second one is רב יהודה, הרב מאיר שינוי קונה. If you go by the רבי מאיר, so you hold that the change by the agent that deviates from the term of his assignment means that the agent acquires the item in question for himself, as in a case of one who was paid to dye wool red but dyed black. And he said, "Veha," and the second brayta divided to two, Rabbi Yehuda de Amar Shinui no kone. So therefore they divided. מעד כיף לרבי אלעזר ממה, הידיל מעד כאן לא קמה רב מאיר אלא במין דחזל אלה גופי. That he needs the item to feed for use by one who appointed by the agent himself, such as the wool dyed the wrong color, which is now not usable for his intended purpose. אבל לסחורה, but for merchandise, no. לא אמר. אלא אמר רבי אלעזר רבי הרב מאיר, ולא קשיא כאן לאכילה וכאן לסחורה. So one is for eating. So that's the appointed desired. The other one is to do business. מחח ולב מערבה. In Eretz Israel they laugh at that. At this explanation from רבי יוחנן. לרבי יוחנן לבד רבי יהודה, וכי מי יודע לבעל חיטין שיקנה חיטין לבעל מעות? Who informed the owner of the wheat, the seller, that he should transfer the wheat to the owner of the money? So if the seller was unaware, that the agent was acting on someone else's behalf, how will the one who appointed the agent acquire the water, the wheat? Now, Rashi here explains the way we understand that that he has a kinyan here, that he acquired it. So matkifla Rav Shmuel bar Sasrati yachei afilu chitin וחיטין נמי לא, אמר רבי אבאו, שני חיטין וחיטין לשליחותי כעביד, וכי בעל הבית דמי. So רבי שמואל בר ססרת, he followed the view of רבי יוחנן. רבי אבאו come and reconcile the view of מערב, ארץ ישראל. Disputation on two matters. One is רבי יוחנן ורבי שמואל בר ססרת, they hold that the dot, the view of the seller, to make kinyan of that schora, of that merchandise, even for the Bala Ma'ot, the owner of the money. Versus Bnei Ma'arav and Rabbi Abahu, they say that it's only for one who makes the kinyan bepoal, that he has physically make the acquisitions. The second one is Rav Yochanan and Rav Shmuel Bar Sars, they hold that when the seller intended to make the kinyan of his merchandise to a specific person, only that person can have that right and have that capability of acquirement, even if he's his agent to another person. Versus people in Eretz Yisrael, Bnei Ma'arav and Rabbi Abahu hold that if the seller wants to acquire for himself, he is basically the agent of another person, so the shaliach can be mezake for the meshaleach. The agent can be the one who can acquire on behalf of one who sent him. Teida says no, that the agent is viewed as the extension of the one who appointed him, like Shlucho Shel Adam Kemoto. Itnan, that's a Mishnah in Tractate Erchin, page 24. Echad HaMakdish Nechasav ve'echad HaMarich Tatzmo אין לו בכסות אשתו ולא בכסות בניו, because it belonged to his wife and sons, so they're not subjugated to the chiyuv neder of him. So it's a limit how much he can consecrate it of those items. ולא בצבע שצבע לשמן, and also not to the color, that he die, that the donor die for his wife and children. And the same, ולא בסנדלים חדשים של כחן לשמם, and not the new sandals that the donor purchased for his wife and children. Presumably the treasurer has no right to these items because they are for the personal use of the donor's wife and children, and I'll consider this if he owned by then. So he said, "Amayle ma'achana me'mi odiyah la'tzaba shikne tzivo la'isha elalam mishum damrinan dishlichutei kavid uchiyad ishto dame achana mishlichutei kavid uchiyad balabai dame." Omer Rabbi Abba lo kol ha'makdish nechasav en dato al ksud ishto uvanav. Matkif la'Rabbi Zera v'chi dato shel adam al tfilav. Right? Tfilav. Right? Tfilav. So they said, Atnan, Amagdish, Nechasam, Malino, Tfilin. So therefore, it can be a Chalot Ekdesh for his wife and sons. Amar lo Abaye, Ein, Da'ato Shel Adam al Tfilin. Amagdish, Nechasav, Savar, Mitzvah, Ka'avidna. Ve'en Da'ato Shel Adam al Ksut, Ishto, Uvanav. Mishum Eiva, it's the fear, it will be enmity that will be engendered if he consecrated their clothing. So that's the idea of Rabbi Abba. I explained that the treasurer cannot collect it from this new clothing that he died for his sons, his wife and sons. מתקיף לרבושה, אבל לא חייבי ערכין שנוכן. So the רבושה ask, but it's not that those who are obligated to do the erkin here. It's also person מעריך את עצמו. That's the Mishnah in Erchin 21. The Mishnah said, חייבי ערכין, that's those who are obligated to ערכין, ממשכנין אותן. So you use it as collateral, even against the will, for the paying of the vow. וכי דעתו של אדם על עצמו למשכנו, a person have upon himself the intent to allow a treasurer to seize collateral from him, we assume not. אלא מרבה, so even though that the nether חל, so אלא מרבי אבא, כל המקדיש נכסיו נעשה כמי שהקנה להן כסות אשתו ובניו מעיקרה. Said any person that was consecrated, his property becomes as one who transfers his wife and his children clothing to them at the outset. So you see here that the clothing did not belong to him at the time that he consecrated his property. And obviously, it's all dependent upon the time, location, and more on that is in Ketzot HaChoshen, Siman chapter, Tzadik Zayin, 97.